Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Mac Outdoors with Mia and Leah. It's been a while. We've had a little break, and on today's show, we will tell you all about what's been going on and who, what, where, when, and why. Stay tuned.
This summer, whether you're at the range or in the field, WSI Sports' HyperTech bamboo tanks, tees, and leggings will have you covered. Visit WSISports.com and use Leah's affiliate code, LLCO10, for 10% off your purchase. All products are proudly made in the USA. WSI is bringing back pride in American-made clothing. Again, that code is LLCO10 for 10% off your order at WSISports.com.
Hey, hey, everybody. Welcome to the Mac Outdoors podcast, where a dynamic mother-daughter duo share their adventures, tips, and advice. I am Mia, and I'll be accompanied by the one and only daughter, Leah. It is time to get to outdoors, hunt, shoot, and spend time with family and friends. Let's get this show on the road.
Welcome back, guys. We're so happy that you're here and that you're tuning in. It has been a while, as we mentioned, and we wanted to just give you a quick rundown and update about what's been going on, because in our last episode, we kind of talked about trap shooting and stuff like that. So Leah, tell us a little about your ending of trap season and how that all went.
So my trap season this year was amazing. It was a lot of fun to shoot up in Montana for the first time by myself. I had rough patches, like getting heat stroke and passing out at a range all by myself, but I got a win at that one, and I got a win at another one in Helena, and I actually was really successful. I moved from a class D shooter to a class A shooter in a matter of 2 weeks, which is very impressive. And I finished my last season with a shoot in Missoula, a local shoot, and I didn't shoot very good at all at that one. I was starting to have extreme back pain and could hardly finish my shooting. We shot in the rain that day, and it was a little chilly, so that didn't help either. But
being cold obviously isn't good for your back, but also you've talked before on other episodes about shooting stance. And so having, which part of your back was hurting, and how was the stance affected by that back pain?
My lower back is what has been hurting, and my stance really, it really affected everything with my stance. I had to stand while I was waiting. I would hunch over because it would hurt so bad, and that was the only way I could get somewhat relieved of it. But it was really hard to stand up straight that day. But really, my stance, you don't want to be hunched over or anything crazy. So that was probably the biggest struggle, was trying to keep my composure of staying on my track to how I shoot instead of trying to change for my back, which I probably should have. But I actually finished the shoot and got second.
Yeah, that's pretty good if you're in severe pain. And yeah, for our listeners, I know that Leah was in severe pain because she called in between some rounds and she literally was bawling because she was hurting so bad. And she didn't know what to do. And of course, as a mom, I'm like, I wish I could fix it, but I couldn't because we were far away. And actually, even if we were there, I couldn't have fixed that for you, right?
I don't think anyone could have fixed that. And I know a lot of people would have just said stop. And I thought about not shooting, but I'd already paid my entry fees and I already was that far through. And so I pushed myself to finish.
And as far as like being in pain, it really wasn't a safety issue, right? I mean, you're safe with your shooting. It was just a matter of you grimacing through
right.
the pain.
It right? had nothing. It wouldn't make me do anything crazy. It just was extremely painful to be on my feet and standing up. And plus with recoil and really holding my stance forward, that was a big struggle, was, you know, you don't want to lean backwards or stand straight. You want to lean into it. And making my abs do the work was a real struggle. Like, it shouldn't be that hard, and it really was, to keep focus on shooting when all you can think is this nagging pain in your back that you just want to cry, but you have to do the next shot was such a struggle.
Right. And so for some of our listeners, in previous episodes, we've talked about a big thing in competition, any competition, but especially in trap, is it's all in your mind. And it really is a mindset, and you have to be in the zone to shoot well in trap. So having a nagging pain obviously is a distraction and causes you to lose a little focus, right?
Yes. And I know if I would have been in better health, good shape that day, I could have easily won the competition. The weather was bad. There were maybe 5 or 6 girls there, and I still finished second when I shot so poorly. I shot in the low 20s. You know, my good days, I'm shooting 24s and 25s every round. So it's hard to go through something like that where you're like, you're being a wimp, when really you're not, as we'll talk about later what happened.
Well, and I commend you, and not just as a mom, but I commend you because you did persevere through that, through the pain, and you still shot well. Over the years, something that you used to deal with when you did the Youth Hunter Education Challenge was, you know, if you start to shoot bad, it makes you feel bad and you do worse and worse and worse. So you actually kept going. You did well considering. I remember one competition, and this is partly how your back pain came about, but one competition in Raton, New Mexico, you were actually on crutches trying to shoot, and that was another tearful time. Did you want to tell people like how you ended up on crutches and why, how you ended up with this back pain and basically how you got where you are right now?
Yeah, so in that shoot, we were, it was horrible weather, of course, and I'm on crutches from basically a basketball injury. I got bucked off a horse the day before this basketball game. That game, I got tackled from behind on my legs and basically kind of stretched everything. It tore the meniscus a little bit. And
yeah,
it was with my knee. And so that was kind of a thing. They tackled me twice before it was into the score table. The second one was my knee, and I remember our coach was like, that one just made you mad when she tackled me in the table. And then the second one, he's like, you can't get up from this one.
So basically, guys, when she got tackled into the table, this was a hit, kind of like a football hit from the side. And this is in basketball. She got slide tackled and slammed into the score table. And so that could have been a cause of the back injury. But when her coach said she couldn't get up, that was a knee thing. And she got actually tackled on the back of her calf from behind as she was on a fast break. And it stretched her knee out, and her coach knew, and all of us in the crowd knew that her knee was like hurt and she was done for that game. And I think because we focused on the knee, we missed the back injury possibly. And as you said, it could have been from the horse events as well.
Yeah. So a lot of things happened all at once, but I recovered from those. It seemed pretty well. I tried to play basketball again, but that didn't work out. They told me I couldn't play a contact sport anymore. So that's when I went to shooting, was because of that injury. But then since I went from this injury to shooting, there was obviously some time where I was shooting on crutches, and they told me I didn't have to shoot since I was hurt, and I was determined that I was gonna do it. And I remember I shot my worst scores ever in all the events, except for muzzleload, which I never did good at. I think I actually did better when I was hurt than when I wasn't, but
it slowed you down. And that's something, maybe we should have an episode about muzzleload, and you got to slow down for muzzleload.
But I just remember how devastated I was. Shotgun is obviously my best event, and I think I hit 5 clays, maybe.
Ooh, I can beat you at that rate.
Yeah, I was so upset because I was shooting so good before that I was like, I'm going to win this one. I have a good chance. And of course, it's my right foot and I'm left-handed. So it's kind of hard to shoot a shotgun when basically you're standing on your back leg and trying to lean forward and shoot and swing, that just doesn't really work out too well.
Right. So for those of you who haven't listened to other episodes, we hope you'll head back and listen to them. But a good stance, you put your weight on your forward foot and you kind of lean forward, bending at your hip joints. So knees and backs need to be in good shape. Okay, so we know how you ended your shotgun season. You actually had a great season, even though your last event was a little rough go. You still got second place. Why don't you tell everybody, you've been at college. That was our big event, was sending you off to school. And so how has school been going, Leah?
It's been a lot of fun. There's been a lot of transition, I would say, from what I started doing before I came here to what I'm doing now. I'm still a journalist major. I'm still going to classes every day that have to do with news and all that fun stuff.
And that's good. And as a parent, I'm very proud to say that she passed all her classes in the first semester, and she's proudly going into second semester. We did get to have her home for Thanksgiving and Christmas. We had her whole Christmas break. She missed fall hunting season, so we tried to get her in some hunts while she was here over Christmas break, and one of those included chasing mountain lions, right? Which is actually episode 2, we talk about mountain lion hunting, but Leah, why don't you tell us about your pursuit of mountain lion and how that went?
Well, that was quite the hunt, especially since I have this back injury that flared up over, I think, the September-October months. So I was still hurting from that, but when they call and say there's a lion, I wasn't going to turn down the opportunity for that. We ended up climbing cliffs, chasing this cat with the dogs. Of course, we were lucky enough to mostly go around these really steep cliffs, but the dogs went straight over, but we circled around, and he's like, okay, 600 yards straight up that way, the cat will be treed. And as we look, oh yeah, 600 yards. And it's directly vertical climb up Colorado mountains with rocks. And basically, we just held on to trees and roots to try to climb up this thing. It took us so long to climb up that the cat had jumped the tree from the first time. Once we got to the top of
that. And that was multiple times, wasn't it? I mean, as far as you, the cat's there and you guys would climb and he had jumped, and then you guys would go to another spot, he jumped again. And so continually you're like, the end is in sight, and then he was gone.
Yeah.
And I mention this because a lot of people say hunting with hounds makes hunting easy. And here is a story Leah learned. It's not easy, right? And you are a very tough hunter, because after you finish telling your lion hunt, I want to share something else about after your lion hunt, what we found out.
Yeah. So it took us maybe an hour, close to an hour, I'm sure, to climb up this 600 yards to where the cat was treed originally. With it being in the cliffs, he wasn't really treed in the trees where we could see him. He got bait up in the rocks. We found where a bed was that a cat was laying, where he could watch this whole valley. We crossed through where a herd of elk had crossed, which means that cat was probably pursuing these elk, which is why it was there.
Yeah.
We ended up just stuck. The dogs had lost the cat. He crossed over his track so many times that the dogs kind of got confused and lost, and we ended up just walking and looking up in the trees just trying to find this cat. Well, it turns out the cat had crossed like two sets of other cat tracks, so we really don't know even if we were pursuing the one that we were at the beginning, that we've ended at the end, because there were sets in between that these dogs had crossed.
And that means there's a lot of mountain lions up there, right? And that's rough, rugged country, so it's a great place for them to live, and they can stalk other game, their prey, and just live up there without a lot of hunting pressure. And something for you, our listeners, why they were able to hunt in this area is because we are very low on snowpack this year. A normal winter, Leah wouldn't even have been able to make it up there. Not even the dogs probably wouldn't have, because usually there's 5 or 6 feet of snow. And this year it was maybe a foot and they were able to climb. So Leah, you had said that you were having a tough time with your back before you even came home for Christmas break. And we made doctor's appointments. So you did this hunt and you survived. And at the end of the day, it got dark. They came home because they didn't want to get hypothermia. And we had to wait for another hunt. But we made appointments with Leah's regular doctor that she's been to for her back before, and her knee and all her injuries. And this doctor was a little concerned, and this is a health insurance issue that on my part. In Montana, she has minimal insurance because in Colorado is her main residence where her real insurance is. So we had to do her appointments here so we can have help paying the bills. Your doctor scheduled x-rays and MRIs and physical therapy and referring her to the spine doc. And why don't you tell us about the phone call that you got with all the results?
Yeah, so that was, it was a tough, I was really hoping that there was something wrong. I know with my knee, they're like, well, there's nothing we can really do besides you just taking it easy and letting it heal itself. And so, like, that's really hard for what we do. I want to hike mountains. I want to chase cats. I want to find sheds. I want to do all that. But with this one, I was like, there's something wrong. I can't sit in the car for more than a couple hours or sit through class. My legs go numb, all this stuff. I got the MRI the day before I left to come back to Montana. So, of course, I had to leave home and be by myself and know that I'm going to get this doctor call. And they called and said, well, you not only have one herniated disc, you have four. All my lower back from my L1 to my S1, all the discs are bulging. And then there's one that's severely herniated bulging disc. So that was shocking because I figured, well, it's probably just one disc. And then when they're like, sent me the full report, it's your between L1, L2, L3, L4, all this stuff. I was like really shocked. I wasn't expecting that kind of report. And then, but what was exciting was they said I didn't need to have surgery.
Right.
Which was the scary part of the whole thing in the first place, because people were telling us stories of, oh, I've had to have rods put in my back, I've had to have vertebrae fused, all this stuff. So
yeah,
I was like, well, what am I going to do if I have to have a major surgery like that when I want to keep pursuing these things?
Right.
But luckily, all I need is steroid injections in where those discs are. So that's an upside of the whole injury.
Yeah, not exciting, but it's better than surgery, right?
Yeah. And I have to do PT once a week until I get those. That's the not fun part to me, but...
And so we get this call while we're at SHOT Show at Range Day, at the industry Range Day. My phone rings and it's Leah. And of course, when your child calls, you answer it. So there's guns and shooting and people ready to say hi. And here I am like pushing everybody away. Like my daughter's calling about the results. And thankfully you don't need surgery. Let's hope that the physical therapy and the shots help everything relax and strengthen what you need to and get everything back in place. Because yes, we have heard some incredible stories, and I'm sure even our listeners probably have a story or two as well. Leah was a little jealous that she didn't get to go to SHOT Show. And so what I'm going to do is try to share some of the items with you guys in the next few episodes. And maybe Leah can give her input and insight on some of them.
As much as I wanted to go, I was happy. Because of my injury, I can't walk very far. So I was like, well, I guess it was a good year to miss.
Yeah. Because was it last year you were gimping around and sore and we had to take
breaks? Yeah, it was the year before. And I hardly walked the whole way. And
yeah.
That was kind of sucky. So Since school started the same day SHOT Show started, I guess it was a good excuse not
to. Right? Can't miss class. You got to get in all those classes. Well, we wanted to give you all an update, let you know where we've been, what's been going on, and we will get back to you with some SHOT Show updates, and we'll also talk to you some about fall hunts and a whitetail hunt that we went on, as well as some elk hunts that I got to go on that Leah didn't get to attend. Until next week, thanks for tuning in. Bye, guys.
Thanks for tuning in, guys. Be sure to follow us on our social media, Mia Anstein and Leah_Huntress, and we hope you tune in next week.